Beauty experts will tell you, you shouldn't put anything on your skin that you wouldn't put in your mouth. So we're going to give you some vegan DIY beauty tips this morning. This is Lisa Kathanicki. She is the founder of Arizona Spa Girls, and she has some yummy homemade vegan recipes that are perfect for glowing skin and plump lips. So good to have you back with us, Lisa. You were sharing with me a lot of these ingredients we probably already have in the kitchen.
Yeah, I mean, I've been experimenting with these in my own time, and I've noticed that I have a lot of things left over, like kale. For some reason, my family doesn't love it as much as I do. So I've been trying out some different things. Yeah.
That's perfect. So some great beauty tips and some wonderful recipes. Let's start with that facial recipe. What do we need?
Sure. So speaking of kale, left over a lot in my house. I did a kale and citrus facial, which is really nourishing for the skin. And all you need is a beautiful piece of kale. You just put it in your food processor, easy enough. And you'll grind it up until you get about this consistency. And then add some lemon, because that'll help get rid of those dead skin cells. And I like oat milk, because that's really soothing to the skin. And so you'll get this beautiful mask. And what you can do instead of gooping it on, because it's kind of messy, is you can get these disposable facial masks and you'll dip it in there and then put that on your face, because that's a lot neater. It's like goop and drip everywhere.
And you know, when you did that, I went like this, because I can just imagine how soothing that feels on the skin. How long should we keep it on?
Oh, just like 15, 20 minutes or so. And that is enough for it to get into your skin. So it's yeah.
Oh, nice and soothing. It feels good. Okay. So what should we do for our body and facial polish?
So, okay. I have a 3-seed body polish for that. And it's sunflower seeds, chia seeds, and flax seeds, which are all really wonderful for you. Great in smoothies and that kind of thing. But in your body, you'll just pop it in the food processor again. And all that does is it breaks up the holes and it releases the oils that are inside. And that makes a really great body polish. All you do is mix it with some oil. I like avocado oil lately. I really like it in food too, but it's a really nourishing oil. And you could pop a little bit of lemon in there. And then you have this beautiful body scrub. It's creamy and it's oily and it feels really good on the skin.
And should we put that on in the shower?
Yes, you can put it on in the shower. Just massage it on. And yeah, it's great.
Oh, that's perfect. And you were saying that the cool tip that you have, maybe get one of those strainers.
Yeah, you can get like a little strainer or drain so that the stuff doesn't go down your shower and goop it up. So that's a handy thing to have with these.
Yes, great tip there. Okay, and we all want plump lips. What do you recommend for that?
Oh, okay. So yeah, I have discovered beetroot, and you can get it in a supplement form. Break open the capsules and you get this beautiful red powder. It's really nourishing. Got some vitamin C in there and other nutrients. Mix it with some sugar. I like organic sugar for these types of recipes. Mix it again with your oil. And what you get is this beautiful sugar polish that you can use on your lips. And when you scrub, it'll leave just a tiny hint of color on your lips. It's really pretty. It's a great thing. You could use it all over your body, but I'd like it for the lips because of the color. Just rinse it off, and then you can just eat it too if you want. That's fine.
So after you do your beauty tip, you can have breakfast. That's perfect.
Absolutely. Yep.
And how often should we do these different types of beauty regimens?
These are like once a week or so, or whenever you have leftover kale, basically, and you don't want to throw it away. So yeah.
Perfect. Awesome. Thank you so much, Lisa. And here's the best part. She has shared all of these recipes with you. You can find them on our website, SonoranLiving.com.